So, the sports, the athletics was very big in this school, in Holy Family. And we always put out a very strong team in every event, like sprinting, hurdles, long jump, high jump, the throwing events, everything. And we practiced and practiced upon the fields back behind the school. And every summer there was a huge annual event for Keighley. It was massive. All the schools took part in the inter-schools sports day. And records were set, records were broken, and it was amazing. It was truly a wonderful time to remember. Trying to think about the teachers at the school. The head teacher was a nun. She was called Sister Mary Campion. I think she became Sister Colette in later days. She was in charge of the school, and there were three other nuns who ruled us with a rod of iron. Very, very strict discipline. The rest of the teachers were just a mixture of male and female teachers, and they were pretty strict. And didn't stand for much nonsense, but in the 1960s, if you misbehaved, it was detention. Sadly, I have to say, I managed to do that on more than one occasion. And detention meant being given a bucket and a brush and a mop, and you had to clean the school. That sounds probably quite shocking to pupils nowadays, but that's what we had to do. We didn't just sit and do nothing. We had to clean the school. Not absolutely always, but it was a fairly common occurrence. We also wrote lines. We had to write out just repetitive line after line of some piece of literature or poem or something. Christian ethos in this school was very, very strong. Very strong links with the church. I think we had mass on a regular basis, confession even in the school chapel. And in May we had a May procession, which was linked to the St Anne's Church, and everybody used to attend a service in the church and then walk it to Cliff Castle and strew petals from flowers and carry flowers with us. And I think it was benediction in Cliff Castle to culminate the day's events, but that was a special occasion.